on RTE1, Mickey's losing control and it's up to TK to pick up the pieces in Shortland Street.
Question. Does passing your part once turn you into a stuffy old bore?
No.
Then scrub up. And tonight we go hard. You're leaving your own party.
Yeah, just for an hour or so, but you know, bubbly's still on me. You don't really mind, do you?
We need a room. A big private room.
Yeah. Yeah.
Leaving already?
What are you doing back here?
This is my party, remember? Have you seen Alice?
She left. Like everyone else.
Oops.
Oh, now you can go back and smooze with the bigwigs some more.
Do you think she went home?
No. She went clubbing.
Right, that would explain why she's not answering her phone. Can't hear the ring over all the ooms, ooms, ooms.
Yeah, that'd be it.
Tell me the truth. She's in a half with me, right?
She didn't look angry when she left.
Phew, I thought I was in the dog box for skipping my own party. Actually, if you're leaving now, maybe I should come with you, wait for her home.
Actually, I've changed my mind. I feel like another drink. Join me?
No, I'm okay. Maybe I should just go home anyway. I only really came to see Alice. Actually, if you do see her, could you do me a really big favour? Just tell her I'm really sorry and I'll make it up to her.
Sure.
George, did George call? Go back to sleep, man.
Oh, it turned on the light.
Oh my God, I thought it was...
Mark, you're damn lucky it wasn't.
I think I'd have to agree with you there. So, if you're not here to take photos,
he
do you
came
mind?
Back to the party looking for you.
What did you say?
I said you went clubbing. I can't believe I covered for you.
I never asked you to.
You're incredible.
Oh, she sure is.
And you're just as bad.
Oh, come on, girl. Tune in with the vibe, huh? Why don't you join in?
Both of you are disgusting.
See yourself.
Oh, could you just please turn out the light?
Can we make this quick, please? Balmoral Prison's finest are on their way.
This is a letter from Ross Clarkson and his counsellor.
In that case...
This is serious. As you'll see, Ross was supposed to phone you to arrange an appointment.
Yeah, he forced his way into my home instead and scared the hell out of Scarlett.
Yeah, well, the counsellor accepts that that was unwise, but you still...
Unwise? Anything could have happened.
But it didn't. The letter is a formal expression of concern at the level of force you use to remove Ross from the house.
Well, tell him to take their formal expression of concern.
Craig, please.
Oh, come on, do us all a favour and tell him to get lost.
It's not that simple.
Why not? You think I was too rough with him?
No, I think you did what you thought was necessary to protect Scarlett.
Look, if you've got a problem, just spit it out.
Well, Scarlett told me about your father.
Oh, and what has he got to do with this?
I just think, given the history of violence in your background...
You're trying to draw a line between my father being violent and me giving Clarkson the heave-ho.
No, I'm just...
Don't worry, save your breath. The meeting's over.
Oh, good morning. Or is it?
Yeah, it's good. It's all good.
What have you got there? Is that a bite or something?
No, it's nothing.
Where'd you get to last night?
Oh, I got waylaid. You know how it goes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was beginning to think that you'd finally moved out until I tripped over your stuff.
Yeah, I'm going to stay at the batch, remember? I kind of need a car to get there. Oh, you know, like the one that was stolen while in your care?
Hey.
Hi.
I'll grab a seat.
Yeah, look, Mickey, you know, I'm really sorry about that, but you know, what can I do? I need my car.
No, it's no big deal. Like I said, insurance will cover it.
Well, yeah. Until the money comes through, you know, just for taxis and stuff.
No, I'm fine.
Are you sure?
Positive. Thanks for the offer, though. I appreciate it.
Oh, I'm going to be so late. See you guys.
I'm impressed. Thought you were going to take that money.
I need a hell of a lot more than that.
Well, I thought you might sort things out with your mum.
The old bag won't give me a cent.
Right.
Look, I promised myself I wouldn't hit you up for a loan. But I owe my dealer big time, and he's already started finding other ways of collecting on my debt.
You mean like stealing your car?
That is just for starters.
How much do you owe?
50k before the car. Now that's down
50
to
grand.
I've got it down to 35. And I'm good for it, TK. Come on, please. You've got to help me.
Bro, even if I wanted to, I don't have anywhere near that kind of money.
This guy is not going to muck around, okay? He means business.
I'm sorry, Mick.
Do you want me to stay alive?
Oh, of course.
Then find me that money.
Okay, the prisoners will be here any minute. Now, I encourage all of you to remain vigilant at all times. These guys have been locked up for a reason. Okay, remember that. It means you too, Alice.
Excuse me. Sorry I'm late.
No, good timing. Okay, guys, here we go. Sarah, you take Itchy over there. Alice, you're with me. Barry, I'm Dr. Valentine. It says here you've been experiencing pain.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Anywhere else? So you've got a history of renal colic as well. It's possibly flaring up again. Put in an IV line, give him 50 milligrams of pethidine and 10 milligrams of metoclopramide. I'll reassess things once the pain is settled.
Have you seen Mark yet?
Not now, I'm not in the mood.
I wish I hadn't lied for you.
Yeah, well, we all do things we regret. You wish you hadn't lied for me, I wish I'd never slept with Mackie. There, happy now?
Then why did you?
It just happened.
It just happened. Is that what you're going to tell Mark?
Of course not. And don't go opening your big mouth. What he doesn't know won't hurt him.
Come in. Mrs. Bowen. What a lovely surprise.
I'm sorry to bother you at work.
Don't be silly, don't be silly. Yeah, here, have a seat.
Do you know why I'm here?
Mackie.
I've never seen him this bad. He was beside himself. Kept asking me for money. Said it was a matter of life and death.
Yeah, I got the same story.
You didn't give him any money.
No, but...
Well, don't even think it. My accountant's instructed me to cut him off before he bleeds me dry. It sounds callous, I know, but the tough love manual says that it'd be wrong to cave in.
Well, one little check wouldn't hurt, will it?
We both know what would happen. It'd go straight on drugs.
Well, no, I don't think it's that bad.
You haven't been around for a while, TK. He started buying small businesses. I had to reimburse him, but I didn't mind. He seemed to be doing something productive. But then my accountant told me it was all a scam.
I had no idea.
He'd inflate the cost of the business and then use the difference to pay for his habit.
What do you want me to do now?
This is the last time. That's what he always says, but it never is.
Rehab.
He won't listen to me or anyone else.
I can try, I suppose, but I can't...
No! You're it. You have to help Mackie.